Welcome. This video is about using multi and complex containers in your boom cards decks. To use a container, drag an item, either multi-choice or multi-picts, onto your card. I'm going to resize and reposition this one. Then I will put my answers in each. First, I'll put in my correct answer. I only have one of those on this one, but you can have as many as you want. Then I will add my incorrect answer. Since all of my incorrect answers are going to be the same, I'm going to use a shortcut and select my incorrect answer, do a copy using my right-click mouse, and then paste to add it to the other boxes. You won't often use this, but if you do need to copy and paste, make sure you use the right-click. It's more reliable. Let's explore grid, flow, and fixed settings. With flow, the correct or incorrect answers, the items inside the container will flow as you change the size and shape of the container. With grid, you specify the maximum width or the maximum number of objects you can have side by side in the container. So here I have two side by side. I will show you 4 and 7, and you'll notice how there's more space as I open it up on those layouts. It will also stretch to fill the space once I let go. Here it's left some space because I still have room to copy in and paste 3 more. This is the fixed setting. With fixed, the items inside the container do not move with the container, but they can be randomized. So here I am positioning in the way I want. This gives me some nice design options. You only want to randomize if they're about the same size. I'm going to show you now with multi-picts. Again, I go ahead and set the size and position of my container that I'm going to have the answers in. And then I select each box and go to my image picker to choose the image I'm going to have in it. With fixed, I do want to go ahead and set the size of each item. You'll see here I'm going to have these be about the same size because I'm thinking I may go ahead and set it to randomize. Only use randomize if each of your images is about the same size as the other. Otherwise, you'll get some very odd results during play. Now I'm going to show you complex containers. We're going to start with a multi-pick. First, we change it to fixed and we turn off randomize items. Then we'll need to get rid of everything but one of the items in the box. You can do it one by one, or you can select more than one and hit delete. Then we need to take the remaining item and make it no longer an answer choice. So I'm going to take it and unflag it from being an answer choice. You can set the full container to be an answer choice, correct or wrong, but not the internal items. I'm going to go ahead and add an image, put it about where I want it, and then I need to bring down a text box. I'm going to put the text I want to have in this complex item. I'm going to format it now, but you can format it later. Now I need to get the text into my complex object. So I need to be very careful that I select it by the handle, that little bar at the top. If I select inside the text, it won't copy correctly. Make sure you're on that handle, click it, and then you're going to use your keyboard shortcut. Only your keyboard shortcut will work. So on a Mac, that is Command C. On your PC, that is Control C. Now click over your image and do Control V or Command V. That will get it inside the box so that it is a complex object. Now I can copy my full complex object by the handle, duplicate it, and have more than one. I'm going to go ahead and make 3 because I'm going to make a simple ordering drag and drop game here. Then I will go ahead and use my tools, alignment tools and other items, to arrange them on the page the way I wish for my design. I'll update the additional items with the text and images that I want to have for my game, getting the fonts just right and arranging everything just the way I want it. Then I'm going to take a button and use that to create my landing objects. I'm doing this because it's already got the text in it and a nice border. It saves me a few steps. Then I will go ahead and duplicate my button so I have enough landing pads for each of my items, because I'm going to have each one land in an individual landing pad rather than multiple items going to a single landing pad. I'll flag each one as a drop zone using my drop zone feature, and then I'll take my complex objects and select each one and flag it as draggable. I'll use little hand, drag it up to a drop zone for each one, making sure they go to the correct place. I'm going to do a greatest to least ordering game here. So again, grab it by the handle, say it's draggable, drag the little hand over to the drop zone, and you're ready. I'm going to go ahead and preview it, see how it turned out. I've put them all in here, but oh, you know, that's not so pretty. Sometimes it doesn't matter if they snap to center, but I think I want this one to snap to center. So I'm going to go back and pick each of my drop zones and add snap to center as a setting for the drop zone. Once I've done that, I will go in and play my game again. Am I happy? Let's see. I made a mistake on purpose to check what happens. Oh, the three stays nicely snapped and the other two go back to the beginning. And much happier. Thank you for watching this video about how to use complex and multi-containers.